The Breakfast Club.
Everybody, it's DJ Envy, Angela Yee, Charlamagne the God. We are The Breakfast Club. And I just want to fill people in, you know, because sometimes you don't see, well, you can't see what's happening behind the scenes. But during the mini mix, when I played My, 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 Charlamagne was up here slow dancing.
Who is Charlamagne? You ain't seen me slow
dancing. That's you.
Slow dancing with who?
You tell me who you was slow dancing with.
I don't know.
He was slow dancing. I didn't even see.
He was slow dancing up here.
Man, Envy, you got to stop doing shrooms in between breaks, man, and coming in here hallucinating.
Yeah, all right.
You might imagine me slow dancing to My, My, My.
I ain't imagine you slow dancing.
But you ain't see me slow dancing to My, My.
All right. Oh, yeah, Revolt's got it, so if you got Revolt, I'm sure they'll show it.
Okay, well, nobody going to see it then. I'm fine with that. If that's where it's going to be seen, I'm fine with that. Okay.
My goodness. Let's get to the rumors. Let's talk Queen Latifah.
Listen up.
This just in.
All the gossip.
The rumor report.
Gossip.
With Angela Yee.
It's the rumor report.
The Breakfast Club.
Well, Queen Latifah recently did an interview with InStyle magazine, mm-hmm. and Tracee Ellis Ross was actually interviewing her. And one of the questions that she asked her was, what was the most difficult role of her career, her toughest career decision? Mm. Well, according to Queen Latifah, what do you think it was?
Let me see. What was Queen Latifah's toughest role?
I don't know.
I don't know. Queen Latifah seems to like do a lot of her roles with ease. I can't.
She said it was a decision to play Cleo and Set It Off.
Oh, stop it!
But Cleo was lesbian, right?
And stop it,
Queen.
Stop it, Queen. She's trolling. Stop it.
Well, according to Queen Latifah, she said it was because of the stigmas attached to gay characters in the African American community. She said, "When I got the role of amateur bank robber Cleo Sims and Set It Off, I sat down with my younger siblings and told them, 'Listen, I'm playing a gay character. Your classmates might tease you or say negative things about it, but I'm doing it because I believe I can bring positive attention to the gay African American community, and I believe I can do a great job as an actor.'"
Isn't that more of a male stigma, though? Like, most men would probably feel like, oh man, I'm playing a gay role, and go have to tell all their friends and family I'm playing a gay role. I don't know if that's actually a woman stigma.
But she killed it, regardless.
She killed it.
Yeah, mm-hmm. She did. Great decision.
Some would say she was typecasted.
All right. Now, Magic Johnson is going to be returning to L.A. as an advisor to the Lakers to help rebuild the Lakers. He's going to be an advisor to the team's owner. And one of the main things he's going to do is bring back somebody to help the team win. And who is that person? He said, first call I make if I'm in charge.
Kobe Bryant.
Absolutely. Kobe Bryant.
Without question.
He said, Kobe understands winning. He understands these players. I would call what role you want. If you've got a day, just give me that day. I'll take that. Whatever time he has, I want him to come and be a part of it. So he said that on ESPN's first
take. And Kobe still can relate to the younger guys, because he's only, a year? Not even a year out the league.
And most of the younger guys probably look up to him.
And they respect him, exactly. A lot of them respect Kobe more than they respect Magic. Just because Kobe was the guy that was, the generation before
them. The era, yeah.
They still were watching him.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Ashton Kutcher was talking to the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, and the main issue was sex slavery. How do we end sex slavery? Well, Ashton Kutcher also talks about different things that he's done and seen as far as being the chairman and the co-founder of Thorn, which is a company that actually fights human trafficking. They built software for that. They're fighting the sexual exploitation of children. And he also, of course, has two children himself, a two-month-old and a two-year-old. So here's what Ashton Kutcher had to say about why he's so passionate about this.
I've seen video content of a child that's the same age as mine being raped by an American man that was a sex tourist in Cambodia. And this child was so conditioned by her environment that she thought she was engaging in play.
I'm not watching that video.
Goodness. I couldn't watch that either.
I'll just take your word for it.
That's disgusting.
I'll take your word for it and fight for the cause. I'm not watching that video.
Can you imagine?
I never want to watch
that video. No, I can't.
How terrible. I mean, he told several different stories that were heartbreaking. And so I think it's really important.
So what's the technology Ashton got? Is like they're gonna start putting chips in kids, or what they're gonna do?
No, the software is actually because they can see like when people are putting these things online, because they have that whole thing called the dark web, which is basically people putting up underage videos.
Porn.
Yeah, child pornography.
I couldn't watch that. I couldn't even say let me watch it to see. Just no,
I take your word for it.
No.
And he also talks about just different tools that they have. He said they created this tool called Spotlight, and that helps police cut investigation time by 60%. So he said that's his day job. He's really trying to help the police and aid them in finding these sex traffickers and these child pornographers and all of that. And he says sometimes people call him and it's a last resort. They can't find these perpetrators. They watched a 7-year-old girl that was being sexually abused for three years and could not find the perpetrator. And he says sometimes we're the last line of defense for these people. Well, here's what Senator John McCain had to say about Ashton Kutcher coming through and actually helping with these investigations.
I also want to thank Elisa and Ashton. And Ashton, you were better looking in the movies.
It's a little one lighthearted
moment. You said that after talking about human trafficking?
It was a lighthearted moment.
Trying to lighten the mood when it comes to discussing human trafficking?
Ashton Kutcher then blew a kiss at him.
I mean, wow. So he wanted to be human trafficked by John McCain is what he's saying.
No, they just had a little fun moment in the midst of all this.
I mean, you got to understand, John McCain is 137 years old. At that age, you hate on any man younger than you. When you get to that age and you suffer from erectile dysfunction, you're mad at anyone who can still get a hard on.
Goodness gracious.
All right, well, I'm Angela Yee, and that's your rumor report.
All right, thank you, Miss Yee. Charlamagne.
Yes.
Who are you giving that donkey to?
I am disgusted by what I saw on social media earlier this morning. It is a young man who is currently trending named Leonard, and he needs to come to the front of the congregation. We would like to have a word with him, and I need to use this as a moment to teach.
Leonard McKelvey?
No, definitely was not. We all can learn a lesson from this young man, Leonard, and this hashtag Hurt Bay that's on social media right now.
All right, we'll get into it when we come back. Keep it locked. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning.
The radio Charlamagne, say the gang, don't get other day, man.